fragole sotto la neve germogliano, non dubitarne mai, non farlo più.
Track 5, Campi di Fragole, or Camp of Strawberries, I believe, in English. This song here is just a great contrast to La Salto de Lupe. I mean, you have the craziest, most anxiety-prone song on the album, followed by the most laid-back, relaxed song. And I love that. You really need, like, the come-down of Campi di Fragole after that song. And, I mean, this is just a beautiful track. I mean, Tony D'Alessio's vocals are so smoky, so laid back, so gorgeous. And it's crazy how in the previous track, Assalto de Lupi, he sounded pure evil. He sounded like melodramatic and crazy. And now it's all laid back. And the intro of the song, the piano intro, it kind of reminds me of 750 anni fa, which was from their album Darwin from 1972. It kind of has a ring of that song. And that song is just one of the greatest ballads of all time. And this one's a really great ballad too. Sure, it's nowhere near as good as 750 mille anni fa. But this song here is, wow, that's a mouthful. But this song here is just, it's just beautiful. It does its job. The bass playing in the background just really accentuates it and gives it like another like layer of texture with that bouncy, like the doom, doom, doom. I don't know. I can't imitate it. But yeah, great song, really great ballad. And I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. I'd say it's just as good as La Salto de Lupi and all the other tracks on the album.
Siamo dei fantasmi senza voce ormai. Ha fatto questo prima, ma pagherà.
And then we arrive at track 6, Lo Sciamano, which means the shaman. And this is another really crazy song in a similar vein of La Salto de Lupi. And I kind of consider this like a turning point in the album, where the album goes from like crazy, unexpected, you know, like just the most creative songs on the album, into more standard Italian progressive rock music. And that's not a bad thing. I'm telling you right now, there's nothing wrong with like the second half of this album. But the first album really throws out all the tricks they have up their sleeves. And the second one, they just stick to their guns and do what they do best. So yeah, Lo Sciamano, it's fantastic. It's another kind of instrumentally extremely strong song. I mean, there's some fantastic 70s style organ playing in the background, some really complicated keyboard and guitar unisons on this song. Kind of, if I listen to this out of context and someone said it was from like the new Dream Theater album, I wouldn't have doubted it. It just sounds very Dream Theater-esque, very like, you know, very musically virtual. Virtuosic, if that makes sense. But yeah, it's a really cool song. There's some heavy distortion on Tony D'Alessio's vocals, creating this kind of sense of foreboding and ominousness, I guess, kind of like trying to convey the shaman in the song, you know, his mystical ways. And yeah, it's just a really, you know, eccentric song on the album. And again, some great classic organ playing, some great guitar and keyboard unison, some really intricate guitar work on this song, and just a really really fun song. I'd give it an 8 out of 10, I believe. 8 out of 10. And I should mention that the main riff of the song does have this kind of spy movie feel to it, like the kind of gives it that like espionage kind of atmosphere. So there's just so many different atmospheres clashing on this song, just closing the first half of the album, the most eccentric half of the album. And yeah, definitely a highlight on the album. Strong 8 out of 10.
Accompagnami alla riva, eterna transiberiana.
Okay, guys, the 7th track on the album, L'Eterna Transiberiana, is honestly probably my favorite track on the album. Either this or a song later on the album, and we'll talk about that after. And this song here is just, it's just one of the most beautiful Banco ballads. I mean, it's just a gorgeous song, and it really takes its time to expand the themes. It reprises a lot of earlier moments on the album, especially from actually only from Stelle sulla Terra, the opening track. So there's like a nice cohesive unison between this song and Stelle sulla Terra, particularly with the industrial beat that comes in about a minute and a half into the first song. And also that ominous organ riff that you hear that opens the song that doesn't really go anywhere on the opening song. They really expanded on this track. And honestly, it's just, it's such a beautiful song. I was talking about Campi di Fragole earlier, how it harkened back to fucking 750,000 anni fa. That, you know, I'm just going to call it the fantastic ballad from now on, because I hate saying that every 2 seconds. But we said how that song kind of harkened back to that ballad. Well, this one here is, it rivals it. I mean, this song here is just one of the most gorgeous ballads I've ever heard in my life. Tony D'Alessio was singing full force, and you could finally see how he was able to replace Francesco Di Giacomo. I mean, his singing on this song is so emotional on so many points. And I mean, there's just a long buildup before it reaches the first climax, and it really takes its time to get there. Like it's like a really gradual buildup up to that point. And then this organ, the organ riff I was talking about earlier that was on Stelle sulla Terra, it comes in, and then it builds up to this interesting section where it's like the melody goes ba 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 na na na, and it's just this weird buildup, and it kind of reminds me of the song "The Cold Song" by Klaus Nomi from the 80s. And I definitely think that was a strong influence on this song. And it just builds up in that sense until it reaches a climax. But then right when you think that that's the climax, another climax follows that. And it's just gorgeous. It ends in a fantastic laid back guitar solo. And it's just the perfect ballad. I was honestly almost brought to tears the first time I heard this because of how beautiful it is. It's hands down a 9 out of 10. Probably the best song on the album. Again, I already mentioned La Discesa del Treno before. That's another strong contender. And then another song that comes up in a few tracks after this could also be the best. So yeah, L'Eterna Transiberiana, one of the best, one of the most atmospheric tracks on the album. You gotta check it out. You have to. Okay, guys, and we're on track number 8 now, Il Ruderi del Gulag. And as I've mentioned before in the video, this song kind of represents the Gulag, which was a prison camp that the Soviets would pretty much imprison anyone and anyone that dissented with their government. So again, kind of fitting in with that Siberian theme of the album. And again, this is another really classic-sounding song. It has a strong jazz influence. A blues influence, believe it or not. There's some parts that sound really bluesy, and that's kind of interesting for progressive rock, especially Italian progressive rock, which kind of distanced itself as far as possible away from like the American influence, because Italy, they were just so isolated at the time. There was all this political shit going on, and they weren't really into any of the American music. But I guess now it's 2019, and a lot of these Italian prog bands, they've obviously heard the American music by now, and I guess they've incorporated elements of it into their sound. And there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, like, I'm not saying this song is full-out American, but it has some, like, saxophone in there. It has some nice groovy, bluesy tone to it. So, yeah, it's a really interesting song on the album. Again, more of a conventional song compared to, like, songs on the first half of the album. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. Like, it's a great song. And, I mean, it has, like, a nice meaty riff to it. It has this cool harpsichord sound in the background that kind of reminds me of a little bit of Heart of the Sunrise by Yes for some reason in terms of the melody. And it's just a really great song. The first song they released from the album. So when I heard this, I was shocked. I'm like, oh my God, Banco's releasing a new album. And to hear this, I'm like, oh yeah, they're really like experimenting with different sounds, like a lot of jazz, a lot of blues. And the guitar tone sounded less European than their previous albums. So yeah, really cool song to check out. I'll probably give this one, I haven't really decided yet, probably an 8 or an 8.5 around there. It's a really good song, really groovy song. And yeah, I don't know what else there is to say about it. It's just really good. And one of the better songs on the album. So check it out. Il Ruderi del Gulag. Okay, guys, and coming in at track number 9, we got the song Lascindo, alla Spalle. And there's not much to say about this song. It's just a nice little piano interlude, a nice little instrumental before the grand finale of the album. And it's just a really effective piece, a really nice little work of art just sprinkled onto the album. I'd give it a pretty solid 7.5 out of 10. It does its job, but it's only about a minute and a half long, so it's nothing to really rave about, but it's a nice little piece. Pretendo sogni enormi come vele in alto mare. All right, guys, so now we're on track number 10. Another masterpiece, and definitely another strong contender for best track on the album. Il Grande Bianco, which at first I thought I read it as Il Grande Banco, because the name of the band is Il Banco, right? So like the big bank. But then I realized Il Grande Bianco, Bianco actually means white in Italian, in English. So I guess the song's about a great white. And it seems like such a fitting title for like the grand finale of the album. Because I can just picture like the protagonists of this album just finally crossing the Transiberiana highway, reaching the ocean, and then seeing this like great white whale. It has that grand and epic feel to it. And this song here is just, it's incredible. I mean, it's so hypnotic the way it starts. It's the most orchestral song on the album by far. I mean, there's a horn section, there's like a string section on this song. It's just some really epic stuff. And it's another one of those like slow burn songs, kind of like the first song, Stelle sulle Terre. But the buildup actually really pays off, because once you reach that climax, there's this awesome guitar solo that just comes in. And it's just, again, like the buildup to that guitar solo was so epic, so orchestral, and definitely has that grand finale feel. And then surprisingly, the rest of the song, it kind of changes into this upbeat, kind of like, I don't know if I'm pronouncing this right, but Z-Hool, like the genre of music that the band Magma created, it kind of like parallels that band with like the sound of the last like 2-3 minutes of the song. And it's just really cool. And I think that the band did try music like this before, kind of like on Cento Mani and Cento Occhi, like the last minute of that song from Darwin. So if you're familiar with that, this is going to have like a similar feel to it at the end. But yeah, just overall really cool song. I just got to mention, the intro has this like kind of like interlocking guitar part that kind of reminds me of King Crimson, the Discipline era of King Crimson, which I thought was really cool. And I forgot to mention it when I was talking about Il Ruderi del Gulag, but the guitar also has a, you know, that Discipline era King Crimson feel with that, you know, that interlocking riff. So really, really cool stuff. Fantastic song. Definitely one of the three highlights. Again, this one, L'Eterna Transiberiana and Discesa al Treno are probably my three favorites on the album. And I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10 because it's just, I honestly think this song's a masterpiece. And it seems from all the reviews I'm reading that most people agree that this is the best song on the album. And I could definitely see why. But we're not done yet. There's still one more track. The closing track, Oceano, Strade di Sale. And it's a really good one too, so
Eccolo. Respiralo dopo questo ghiaccio estraneo. Ritornerà la marea, richiamata dalla luna, senza tremare.
Alright guys, the last song on the album, Oceano Strado di Sale. I love this song, guys. After a long album like this, well, relatively long, it's about 50, 55, 56 minutes. It might be easy to start zoning out at this point, but don't zone out on this final track. This final track is amazing. It's by far the most conventional, it's by far the most conventional and straightforward song on the album, but I love it. I mean, if Il Grande Bianco is the grand finale of the album, think of this as like the music that plays during the credits. I mean, it's energetic, it pumps you up. It has like a great riff playing throughout. Some classic 70s organ throughout the entire song. And it's just, the riff just chugs along at a fantastic pace and it just pumps you up to the max. I mean, this is the most conventional song Banco wrote, but definitely one of the catchiest. And I literally have no idea why they didn't release this as a single, because it's just so catchy, so uplifting. The organ is just so classic sounding. I think people would have definitely enjoyed this a lot more than the other singles that they put out. I'm just generalizing. I think it's way more accessible than the singles they put out, but I still respect them for putting out what they did, because, you know, they did put out a lot of like the more experimental songs like Assalto dei Lupi and L'Imprevisto and things like that. But I think if they put out this song, it could have gotten a bit more mainstream attention, because it's just great. And it's just a great way to end the album. I wish it was a bit longer, because clocking in at 3 minutes, it just kind of ends kind of abruptly. And I would have loved if it kept going and did some like instrumental stuff. But I'm just greedy. I mean, this band here, they gave us a fucking feast of an album. And here I am complaining about like the last song being 3 minutes. So shame on me. But Oceano Strado di Sale is just a great song. Honestly, one of my favorites, like outside of the top three, it's probably like my fourth or fifth favorite song on the album, believe it or not. Although it is a very conventional song, I'm going to give it an 8.5 out of 10. I just love it. It pumps me up and that's all I need right now. So fantastic way to close the album. And that's it, guys. That's the album. You know what, guys? I'm going to give this album a strong score, a really strong score of 85.46%. So it definitely cracked my masterpiece tier one. And I really do think this album is a modern classic. It should be heard by any progressive rock fan of the modern age. And again, I'm just so happy that Banco released this fantastic, unexpected album. I mean, it's just a gift. It's a real gift for me. And I've been listening to it nonstop since it came out earlier in 2019. And it's one of those albums that just keeps growing and growing and growing on you. So keep on listening to it. Keep on, you know, getting into the Italian music scene, because it has so much to offer. And I can't wait to see these guys live. I hope they do an American tour, a North American tour. I know they probably won't, because I've seen like their previous gigs and they've all been in Italy. And I'm not going to Italy anytime soon. I'm trapped here in Canada, you know, just trying to finish off school, trying to work and all this. But God damn it, hopefully I can see them at least once before they disband. And hopefully they have another fantastic album like this up their sleeve with the new lineup. Cause it's just, it'll be a shame if this was a one hit wonder, if this was the only album that they released. So I'm going to conclude the review here, guys. Thanks so much for watching. It's been awesome. Just chatting about this like fantastic album. And comment below your thoughts on the album. You know, which songs are your favorite? Which songs are your least favorite? You know, am I overrating the album? Or am I underrating the album? Let me know. And take it easy, guys.